Oh, hi, Joey here. Back to our acoustic blues, and I've got an old song called Careless Love that I've done once before, but I want to redo it. I wasn't happy with the first time it came out. Great acoustic blues song because it's sort of, the melody of the song is relatively easy to play. But then you get some really nice fills in between the lyrics, which makes the whole song really worthwhile. So I'll show you what I mean. We're in the key of C, so we're predominantly doing this alternating bass line, then the G, and of course the F. But then you get some other odd little chords here and there that add a lot of interest. So let's put up the first four bars, Careless Love. And I'll just play these four bars. So, I've just stopped on the third bar there. So you can hear the melody. Pardon my singing, please, but this just to give you an idea of how the song's meant to go. Love, oh love, oh careless love. So that was the fourth bar I played then. We've got this nice slide going up to the eighth fret. So when you're in this C position, you're playing the bass note, C note, and then an octave higher, the C note, and you slide that up, you're playing the F bass, octave higher F, and then you're playing that third of the F chord, that's an A note. So you are effectively playing the same as this. You're effectively playing. So when I first learnt this song, and I thought, oh, you know, my teacher would add this massive slide, and you think at the time, I thought, oh, God, I can't do that, you know, in time. And so I started doing this easy way. And I got used to just doing it the easy way and forgot all about the big slide. And I only remembered the big slide when I dug out my old notes, you know, 4 years back, when I started playing guitar again. Oh, that's right, there used to be this big slide. So I've incorporated the big slide back into my playing, which is nice. So what I suggest is, if you find that slide difficult, you know, because you've got to do it within a beat and get back to the C, stay up here and do that F here. Just to help you complete the whole song, but always think about working your way towards being able to go. Okay, and there's another moment where there's another big slide and there's an easier way to play it, so I'll show you that easy way to play it, but I'll also show the slide as well. So we'll go to the next four bars, and then that line, love, oh love, okay, it repeats three times, so you can hear it as I play the melody. So we're up to bar five. So there's another big slide. Now we're only up to the bar six there. So play that C again. Now here, you're on an A bass with a very high two octaves up, a very high A. And there you're playing part of an A7, which is this A note and this G note. So you're effectively playing this. So you could play, yeah. So once again, you could play this easier bit. So for the sake of being able to learn the whole song, try that, but always think about looking out to the big slide because, well, it adds a lot of interest to the song, yeah? And then you're in this D position. And you've got this nice fill in bar 8 under the G. I'll just play that bit again. Back to the C. 7th on that C chord, and you now you're up to the F on bar 11. This nice triplet. We'll do that again. Now we're up to bar 12 to close all that out, and you've got this run of diminished chords, starting with E diminished, F sharp diminished, A diminished, C diminished. Now I don't want to spend too much time on this because I've done this once before, explained diminished chords, but there's a certain magic to diminished chords. We're starting on that E flat, and if you can imagine, there are 12 notes to get up to the octave of E flat, and with a diminished chord, it includes every third half step. So E flat, F sharp, A, C are all part of the E flat diminished. Then if you work your way to the F sharp diminished, you have a F sharp, C, E flat, A. And if you work up to the A flat, the A diminished, you have A, E flat, F sharp, C. And if you work up to the C diminished, you have a C, F sharp, A, E flat, and then the E flat will have all those notes again. So in other words, every position of that diminished run are the identical notes. In other words, E flat diminished contains the same notes as F sharp diminished, contains the same notes as A diminished, contains the same notes as C diminished. That's the magic of diminished chords. So we've got this beautiful run in that bar, 13th bar, and hold it for two beats afterwards, because don't forget, it's a very comedic song, so we're adding lots of comedic parts, yeah, to add to the song lyrics. And we're back to that first line. Then you got this nice comedic run. Another 2-4 bar we're holding it for, and then we repeat. And then at the very end, I'll put the end up now, a slightly different ending. We're back to the up to bar 19, the ending. There's a second repeat, and we've got this nice run again. And that's a nice ending. That's a sixth chord. We're going from B6 to a C6. That's a nice little way to end it. So that's just two repeats. Why don't I'll put my Guitar Pro on. We're playing this at 102 beats per minute. It's a relatively slow pace, but it's a good pace to allow us to, you know, get those slides in, to get that F trip, the triplet that you got to play. So we want to be able to get that in, and we want to be able to get this in. Because even sometimes I forget what fret I'm meant to be on when I'm doing that. So it's a good all-round tempo to get all those things in, but otherwise, for the rest of the song, it's a relatively slowish pace, but it's a nice one to practice too. For those new to acoustic blues playing, you won't get this straight away, but practice it and try and play along with me and try and work up to the tempo that I'm playing at, which I think is achievable. Okay, let's have a go at doing that. Thank you. Thanks for watching.